Thanks to you. And now by last but not least, we have Dr. Núria Huguet, who was in the group of Professor Antonio Maria Chavarren, and she is currently working in the BASF. And I have to say that from my point of view, it's an honor to introduce her because we were really good friends when she was at ICIQ. So thanks, Núria, for accepting the invitation. And she will give a talk entitled Mastering the Unknown Path. But of course, Núria, we also have a video for you. So let's see if I can share this and enjoy it.
Núria Huguet was born in Valencia, and she came to the ICIQ in 2013 to join the group of Professor Antonio Chavarren, where she was working on cyclization of enines, in particular 1,5 enines. After that, she moved to Heidelberg to do a postdoc in the Catalysis Research Laboratory of BASF, where she was working under the supervision of Professor Michael Limbach in alternative synthesis process for the for the synthesis of acrylates using CO2 as building block.
So in October of 2014, Núria went to the BASF in Ludwigshafen, and she joined a laboratory as a team leader in the Department of Homogeneous Catalysis and Process Development.
Núria left the group before finishing her PhD to do an internship at the BASF, where she was in charge of a research project, and at the same time she was writing her PhD.
In 2013, when Núria finished her PhD, she came to BASF to make a fellowship in the lab. What I have to say, at this time I was already there, so yeah, so we were like really joined to see, really happy to see us again, and to share our like good moments, also to remember a good moment from the ICIQ. And what I well remember from this time when she was there is like, yes, I think everyone realized that Núria studied at BASF. She really started just like a fellowship, like in the lab as a normal technician, and she was making all of them like crazy. I have to say, like from the boss until the technician. In June 2018, she left research and started a career path in production as process manager operation excellence amines, where she was responsible of innovation projects, working as the bridge between business and production.
In 2019, she took her actual position as process manager alkanolamines, where she is responsible of the plan optimization, safety and innovation.
From my part, what I remember most of working together with Núria and what she brought to the group of Echavarren was her very thorough and hard-working attitude with always a smile on her lips.
I think all of us remember Núria as a very enthusiastic person, pure energy, and one of her hobbies was, and I think it is, still is dancing, and she was always dancing around the lab while performing the reactions.
Núria is very passionate about dancing. She has done a lot of classical dance as well as contemporary dance. And I remember when we were doing the PhD thesis, she introduced me to her teacher and her ballet school. And since that moment, we were together doing some ballet classes after the lab work.
But what I mostly remember from, we actually had our fume hoods next to each other, and she seemed to always have a column running. So it seemed like she was always doing so much synthesis, and but always with a smile. So she was one of the easiest co-workers I've ever had.
She really wanted to try new things, improve it. Like she was really working with the glove box. I was like, this is not the way to work. This is unbelievable. We cannot make it like this. So, and I'm really happy that she has been since, oh my God, this is my second year of PhD. She has been always at my side in all these many years.
Well, Núria, so now it's time for you to present. The screen is yours.
So, well, Núria, how are you?
Now I understand why when I arrived, because I'm sorry that I was late, I couldn't make it before, but I came into the meeting when Noelia was super nervous and you were telling, can you talk? And I was like, okay, maybe.
What's happening here, no?
Yeah, but okay, now I assume that all of us, we had a kind of presentation with our old colleagues, and it's really emotional, I have to say. But thank you very much to all of you that you were talking. I will talk with Anna because I was last weekend with her.
I know.
Anything. But yes, thank you very much for inviting me to this first alumni event. I'm really happy to be here. I will try to do my best because I'm not used to do these Zoom things, even if everyone is working from home office. And yeah, thank you very much. Sorry, Margot, that I could not make it for your talk, but I assume that will have been amazing to attend. And I'm sure that you are still the strong woman that I saw. And like Noelia, I really love your talk. I'm sorry that I cannot show so much pictures and things about science, since in the company is everything confidential. But I hope that I can bring to you what my career path was and is, and how I reached the point where I am and who I am. That's also, I think, important. Judith, I assume that my screen is already there?
No, we cannot see it now.
You cannot see it?
No, maybe you can try to share it again.
Okay.
And if you try to, maybe it's easier if you share now.
Now is. I do it again.
Now, yes. Now we can see it. If you put it in presentation mode.
Now.
Yeah, exactly. Perfect. Thanks.
So I think my colleagues already present me that well, but yeah, I'm Núria. I'm coming from Valencia, from Spain. That's a really nice and friendly city that if you can, that's only 550 kilometers from Tarragona in direction south. And yeah, I really recommend you to visit it. So I started there my journey since I was born there. And I love the picture that I have in the middle because I think that's describing myself quite a lot. My colleagues already said I'm a ballet dancer. I did that in parallel to my school and to my studies from chemistry. I never give up. Even Corona didn't stop me because we could dance at home with Zoom, even if it's not the same, but I'm still dancing and it's the way that I have to forget everything what's happening at job and keep this professional, personal balance in my life. I love traveling. I love to go to the beach. I'm missing that a lot. I love to do, that was one of the best things to do the PhD also at the ICIQ, that you can be working hard, but then you can go for a walk on the beach and relax yourself. Here I changed the beach for the mountains, since the Alps are also quite close. I'm living now in Ludwigshafen, sorry that I didn't say that, where the BSF is. I love science. I never gave up with that, even if I'm in a company where you can develop yourself in other areas, not only chemistry, but I will talk about that later. I'm a really happy person. I try to keep that and always with a smile and making crazy the lab, the production where I am. That is a thing that also I think that it's making the difference that you also need in this company world. You need to be different as the rest and not only in the way of science or with your soft skills, as well as Noelia say that, make the difference. I love culture, or everything what is with music, with dance, books, museums, traveling, visiting cities. I love all of it and I'm looking forward to it again. So far this pandemic is gone, or at least not so harder.
I learn, I do always think out of the box, because that's also a thing that I've seen during these years that it's helping you a lot. Or you have also to do, you cannot keep always thinking on the same way and in the same box. You have to, when you take decisions where you are looking in which direction your team has to go, the plant, wherever is your task, it's always good to think out of your established thing, so to say. I love challenges. Not all the challenges that in life are coming, and there are challenges that you cannot choose, but there are challenges that you can bring yourself, and it's this comes together with this going out of your comfort area, challenge yourself, go for new things, go out for the things that makes you comfortable in this life. And since I was a kid, I think I know more or less what I wanted in this life or what I would like to achieve. And I am quite a goal-oriented person. Just to tell you a bit about where I started and how I did my career until now. As I said, I studied chemistry in Valencia. And I assume that why in Valencia? I've never thought about that until I started to move abroad. I assume that maybe for most of the Spanish people was the same. I've never thought about another possibility before. So you studied hard in school, high school, in order to become a good mark that allows you to enter in the university in your city. And then you move, or at least the people that I knew was moving because they couldn't enter in the university close to home, or because the studies that they wanted to do, they weren't there for availability. So I was lucky or not lucky that the chemistry university was 10 minutes walk from my parents' place. So I was the typical Spanish girl that studied at home with the parents, didn't have to work in parallel to pay the studies or whatever. So I was quite comfortable there, studying hard like always and dancing at the same time. And I think also this combination from study and doing already my ballet bachelor also make the person that I'm at the moment, because I learned how to organize myself. I learned how to use every second of my time in order to improve for my studies, in order not to waste time, and in order to get to learn as fast as I could in the shorter time and getting the best marks that I could in my life. That gave me a lot of discipline. Ballet is also a really hard, tough and give you a lot of discipline, but also you need to listen to your colleagues. You need to dance together. There will be times that you were dancing alone and there were times that you were dancing in a team. And this looking to your colleagues, listen to them, that also make or that helped me to the point that I am to be able to be a single contributor in my job or my studies, and work also in a team, be able to work in teams in the university, in my PhD, in the company. So everything started from the beginning. From Valencia, like most of the people, I took 1 year for Erasmus. And this challenge pushed me a professor that I had in the University of Valencia, because I wanted to leave, but I was really comfortable at home. And I was thinking, why should I leave if I already decide that I will do my PhD in Valencia, no? Because I was a girl that even if in summer holidays, I couldn't stop. I was having fun, I was going out, but also I took the time in summer to go to the laboratories from the university because I wanted to know what really research was. And at the same time, I was also dancing in summer. So I was always being busy and keep going and trying. I didn't want to sleep, I didn't want to stop. And thanks to this professor, he pushed me. And at the end, I decided to go to Cambridge also because of the language. English was the language that I could at that moment. And it was easier for me. And also because I always loved these colleges from Cambridge, Oxford, and Valencia had a collaboration with Cambridge, and it was the university that I could go. There I had my first contact about being in a real research group, like was with Professor Stephen Lay. We were at that point already 50 people on the group, doing a lot of synthesis of natural products, really challenging. Each colleagues challenging themselves with retrosynthesis. I was amazed because I was thinking, okay, this is my fifth year of chemistry. And I have the feeling that I didn't learn enough, that maybe I wasn't challenged enough. And I got a really nice experience there. I was able to do this kind of chemistry, not as the synthetical chemist with columns and doing the reactions in batch. There the challenge was to do the synthesis path with flow chemistry and microwave chemistry. And for me, there was like, wow, it's like I've never seen that in my university. And it was a really nice first contact with a bit a plant now would be, but in really small scale, really, really small scale. My Erasmus also allowed me to see that a lot of young people didn't stay at home studying chemistry. There were a lot of people that I met in that moment that they were coming, of course, for other countries. And they really knew from the beginning that after high school, they wanted to study chemistry or other degree in Cambridge, in Oxford, in a really well-known university from this world. And I was surprised, like, wow, they are really, how to say, really, I'm so sorry, I'm with the German the whole day, and now I'm challenging myself with the English, but really looking to the front, going through the challenge, taking the unknown path, as you say. And that was my first contact where I say, well, there is more work, there are more decisions to take, I don't have to go back to Valencia. I was also surprised that people coming from other countries, they didn't even thought about taking a sabbatical year to think in which topic I would like to do my PhD. And I was like, whoa, I've never been grow up in this direction. Like for me was everything like it should be and with all the path already written. And there is when I decide to change, I say, no, I don't want that for my life. I don't want to go back to Valencia. I want to do another kind of chemistry since I saw that there were so many possibilities, so many universities, and that you can go. You have to ask for grants. You have to write, as Noelia said, to apply for all these grants so that you can make it if you want. And there is where I get to know the ICIQ because one of the colleagues there was trying to apply for a postdoc. And then I started to make research on the internet and I saw that the ICIQ was having a program that it was the summer fellowship. And I applied and I joined the ICIQ in the summer from 2008 for 3 months of fellowship with Antonio doing gold chemistry. And then I really enjoyed the ICIQ so much and the chemistry, and it was so nice to make research there with so new equipment, so many facilities, that at the end I ended up there doing my PhD until 2030. As my colleagues already say, in the cyclization from amines and application to synthesis from natural products. As all of us did during our PhD, I did a short stay with Tobias Ritter in Harvard University in Boston. So there I decided also to move to the US and see how chemistry and how people was living there. And I decided to do also another kind of chemistry because I didn't know what I wanted to do then for my postdoc, but I knew that I wanted to do a completely different chemistry for my PhD.
even if I couldn't use that at the end for my thesis. And there I was doing synthesis of natural products, but with fluorination chemistry. And that was super interesting because we had a collaboration with the Harvard Medical School, and I could see an application about this chemistry. And then is where also I confirmed for myself that maybe I didn't want to go for an academic career, and I wanted to do something that I could apply maybe in the industry or in medicinal chemistry, but I didn't want to go to a university and do, as Noelia said, this fight to get your position, to fight for your group, start from zero, and maybe having to give lectures to the students. Because if you would have asked me as a kid, what do you want to do? I wanted to become at that point a teacher. As far as I learned chemistry in the school, I said, well, I will be a teacher in the university. But then I decided, no, I don't want to do this kind of research. And it's where I got to know BSF in one of the conferences. And also in our group by Antonio, I had Elena and Anna, that before of me, they did an internship in BSF, and they were talking really good about this time. And I decided, why not? I want to do the same. I want to get to know the industry. I don't want to only see the part of the academical world. I also want to have experience in the industry and decide, since I wasn't sure or almost clear that I didn't want to do this academical career. And then I was, as Pili said, I left the group as Anna and Elena in the moment that we started to write our PhD thesis. That means that while I was doing this internship in BSF, I was writing my thesis, and I was doing that in the evening after doing my research there. There I found a completely different world where the people that had a PhD, they weren't in the lab. They were driving the projects, coordinating, and being the head, thinking head, as our group leaders, but they weren't in the lab. So PhD students working more or less as a postdocs, but you didn't have to go to the lab and doing the reactions alone. As a lab team leader in BSF, I realized that the people was coordinating, doing the projects in the way that they had interaction with engineers, with marketing, and I really liked that. Also, I saw how nice was to do the PhD in the ICIQ, since in the industry, or at least in BSF, a big point is the safety. So that means that each time that you are gonna put one reaction, you have to go through papers and challenge yourself and the technicians what could happen. Because if something happened, you are the responsible of the person. While I was there and I decided, okay, I would like to work in this company, I get to know Mikhail Limba, and he put me in contact, or he showed me this postdoctoral center from the BSF, Carla. And at the end, I landed up there doing my postdoc for 1 year and a half, where I was carrying out research for the BSF, but research from the really beginning. So projects that could be part in 10 years, 15 years for solving actual problems for the BSF. So really early projects from the industry carried out from postdocs that we can carry out this research much faster as in the company. And if the project were successful, then these projects were transferred to the company. And during this year, there in this postdoc center, I started to get my first contacts with BSF. I could say again, yes, it's where I wanna be. I wanna be here. And there I was working with ethylene and CO2. To find alternative synthesis for sodium acrylate from acrylic acid, because as you maybe know, this acid or sodium acrylate starts the synthesis or the production from propylene, and the price from propylene and ethylene oxide is always is always going up and going down in the market. And BSF wanted to be ready just in case we have to jump with ethylene. And of course, CO2 is a hot topic at the moment, and we have to reduce the emissions from CO2. And I was doing research there, trying to activate this molecule. And after 1 year and a half of postdoc, I was lucky because my project was transferred to BSF, and they had an open position, and I could start in the company in 2014 as a lab team leader, as this position that I saw, that I was the thinking head of the projects of the homogeneous catalysis and process development department. But I have a team of 5 to 8 people where they were my hands. So I was the head of the team and they were the hands. But these people, I mean, they are really well-known trained. I got to know apart from BSF that I didn't know. And it's the way that they are forming the technician. And that's really well-known here in Germany, in the whole Germany. I was also surprised because in Spain at that point, not to go to the university, or at least in my family, was not so really well known. And here a lab technician is super well trained. So they are so good in this path to form the people that they are amazing in the lab. So they can do if I was running 2 columns, okay, in the company we are not running column, that's another way of work up, but the things that I was doing maybe in a week on my PhD, they could do that in 2 days. So I was really, really surprised. During this period of lab team leader, as I say, I have my team of 8 persons, depending on the projects that I had, and I was doing high pressure hydroformylation most of my time, because the projects there were always in contact with the plants. So I had to support the research troubleshooting from our production plant for the hydroformylation. And at the same time, I was still developing this chemistry, CO2 chemistry for natrium acrylate. I was working there, as I said, in process optimization, and that showed me a part of the chemistry that I also didn't know. That was how to apply all the know-how that I had from my PhD, but in direction production. So the production plants are there. They were a big monster. I thought when I started in the BSF that all the chemistry that we had inside was really well known. But when you are there, you realize that you cannot control everything, and that even we have plants running for a lot of years and the chemistry should be well known, the chemistry can still surprise ourselves. And I really enjoy this time of my life in BSF because I was really involved solving the problems in production. I could understand the impact that this was having with the customers outside or with the Verbund. The Verbund is a really well-known word in the BSF world, but the meaning is the connection that we have between the plants, because in the site from BSF that you can see here in the picture, sorry that I didn't introduce it, that's all this here is the BSF. That's 10 quadrat meters, kilometer from site. We are at the moment around 35,000 workers there, so it's like a small city. It's amazing. We have our training site, we have our buses inside. So when I entered the first time in BSF, I really was amazed. You can see the river there, so we have different harbor there. So this Verbund is all the connection that we are having between the different plants. So that means that one plant after the steam cracker, it's sending all our products to the different plants from BSF, and it's a chain. So that means that if one of the plants are having a problem at the moment, what this would be the impact of the company? If the chemistry is not working, if suddenly you have a side product that wasn't expected, or values depending on the specification of the customers, this could be a really big loss for the company in sense of money also. Because in the moment that you stop one plant, you have to think about all the connection between all the plants, and that a big company cannot afford that. So, I mean, it was really interesting the other kind of working here in the company. Also in this position, I had to lead with project management. As I said, working with engineers, so I had the know-how from the chemistry, but it was really nice to put everything, all of my knowledge together with other parts of the scientific world. So working with engineers, seeing how they were putting all the reactions or the thing that I was developing in my head in bigger reactors, or trying to bring that to reality. So it wasn't only in the paper, it's like we are bringing that to make something in life with that, to help something here. Then after being 4 years there, I decided and came also the opportunity to go as process manager, operational excellence. I changed from hydroformylation to amine synthesis from amines. And there in the first year, I was doing innovation projects. Innovation from the sense, what do we need as company? What do our colleagues from marketing need that to fulfill the needs from the customers? And then these innovation projects were related with chemistry, couple productions, changing some part of the plant in order to achieve what the customer wanted. And I really, really like it. And it's where I decide I want to be here in production, and that's for me. Also, because from the team of 8 person or 5, I'm now working in an environment with 100 people. So we are 95 people in production in our plant, and at the end you are the single contributor while working in a big family, and at the end you need from all these different person in order to achieve the goal. So in this year I was also working or trying to do a smart production increase, so trying to make the chemistry working better in order to spend less raw material but producing more, and also trying to reduce the idle time from the plant. At this time is the time where we are doing cleaning processes, so the plant is not producing but still has a cost, and that was the goal that I had at this moment. There I was also the bridge between marketing and production, so I really liked that position because I was with one foot in the production and one foot with marketing, so I could see also the part of the business. And I started, not started, but there we had to come with a lot of strategical thinking in order to make the chemistry to come to the reality. And since 2019, so since 2 years now, I got also a process manager position, but more focused in alcanola mines, also in production, where I'm now the focus is on the plant safety, a big challenge here when you are working with ethylene oxide, propylene oxide, ammonia. I'm responsible from the process optimization of the plant. So that means all the chemistry that is going inside, trying to optimize the process, checking if temperature efforts, pressure could bring better yields or reduce side products. I'm not working with catalysts, but if there was the case, you should be also optimizing the selectivity and the yield from the catalyst. Also, I'm really focused to introduce new products to the plant. That means that I'm still a lot in contact with the research and marketing still, because marketing is coming and is telling you the customer would like to change this part of the molecule, or these are the needs in chemistry from the customer, and we have to go with research and at the end make it possible in our plant. And this all this escalation from the lab to the pilot plant to the plant is also on my hands together, and so it's also still a kind of research, and I'm still enjoying that part of research. Also, one of my tasks that I'm doing now is leading with energy and quality management. The big plants are spending a lot of energy, a lot of vapor, a lot of CO2 emissions, a lot of electricity. And of course, one of the challenges is to try to produce the most, reducing all these parameters. and trying to avoid to these emissions to the environment that will kill us as company. What I will do next, that's the question always in this company, and the nice thing that I like is that I will come later to that. You can do different things. So I started in research, now I'm in production. You have a lot of contact with marketing, with business. You can develop yourself in a strategical department. You can change to business. Of course, since I'm inside ESF and that all the work is there, you go through seminars if you are interested in business, if you are interested in marketing. So all what you learn in your PhD, you can apply to other parts of different segments of the company, but also you can develop yourself as a professional and as a person. Why did I choose to go to the ICIQ? All of you know the ICIQ, I think, is the best institution. I mean, it is the best, one of the best institutions that we have in Spain, and really competitive with what is around the world. I decided to go there because I wanted to work with the best professors. I wanted to do high quality research. I wanted to work in an environment that is competitive. And one of the most nice things in the ICIQ was the people, the international environment, all the help and all the support that I got from the colleagues, learned from others, other cultures. You could do fast chemistry. I mean, we could run NMRs as much as we wanted. I assume that now, I don't know how it is now, since the ICIQ is bigger, but I remember there, we were running at that moment with all GCs, with all the NMR. I mean, was really nice way of doing chemistry. Also the opportunity to go for conferences, international and nationals, to get to know people. That's a thing that Noelia also was saying, this networking. Networking, I think, it's one of the most important words that I've heard in the last years in BSF. Networking is really important. So if I got also this contact with BSF was because I got the opportunity to go to the winter school from the BSF, and I get to know the person that put me in contact to do my internship in BSF, and after that, the postdoc. So everything is about connections, getting to know people, and develop yourself also. What the ICIQ also brought to me, it's not only these scientific skills that, of course, we develop ourselves there a lot. It's also the development of your soft skills that at the end are going to be also important for your career. So as I remember, we had every week these group meetings where we had each of us at some point, we had to present our results. We had to present papers, talk about other chemistry, solve problems. All these things that we were doing in Antonio's group helped me to be also the person that I am, to apply all these challenges, all these solving problems, learning from others, learn to listen and work with the critics from your colleagues. All these things helped to me to achieve the different positions that also I had yet now in the company. Of course, all the presentations that you are doing in the ICIQ, the opportunity to present in conferences, all these things, this presentation skill, communication skills. I remember that we were at some point a bit upset, no? That I'm presenting here and Antonio was saying until the comma, where you have to put the comma. And we were saying, wow, how picky is Antonio? But at the end, all these things, at the end you are grateful because this persistence, this constant, this all these tiny little things that you think, wow, we are wasting our time. No, that's building yourself. And all these things can you apply later, as I say, in your career. Also the teamwork, doing your PhD, most of the time you are challenging yourself alone. You are putting synthesis, you are trying to go for a project. Sometimes it's not working, but you keep going. And at the end, if you cannot do it alone, you are asking your colleagues. You are asking, you sit with your colleagues, you discuss the mechanisms, you ask for the help from your postdoc that already had a PhD and were helping. And all these things I can apply now to my daily life or to the challenge that I'm getting in the company. As I say, always going out from your comfort area, challenging yourself, going out from the box, helped me. And why I decide to, I wanted to remark all again, this well-known group leaders, high quality of research, conferences, networking, is at the end one of the most important things that during these 4 years of PhD, I think about it, because without Antonio, without discussions with also Ruben Martin, with Arian, with Pablo Ballesteros, with all of you that you were there, also when we wanted to go for a postdoc, asking where would you like to go, sending this email with recommendations, with all these kind of things, that's like the first idea also that you get to go to the external world. So I'm really thankful of all this opportunity that at the end helped me to be here in the company, to build my career and to keep going. BSF, and I assume that I will speed up, I decided to go there because it is a global company. So you find BSF all around the world. It has operations, I really like production. So I really love to the chemistry that we learn in the books, the chemistry that we thought our basic chemistry at the end could be more complicated than you think and could bring to problems that with the book you cannot so easily explain, and how picky can be a specification from a customer. Also, it's a company that is driving innovation in research in the different business of so negotiation that they have. You have different art of chemistry, so you can go for agro, you can go for polymer chemistry, you can go for pharma, you can go for cosmetics, you can go for coatings, automotive. So the spectrum that you have there to do chemistry in different areas, you don't have to keep always doing the same. So I saw there an opportunity to don't be stuck, so to continue growing professional, and of course all these things are also making you growing in your personal stuff. So I saw there the possibility of developing myself, working in a diverse atmosphere, having maybe the possibility in the next years to be working abroad, not staying here in Ludwigshafen, and I could improve myself, keep going, fight, and go further my limits, you know, to get to know parts of myself that I didn't know. I'm now also leading kind of businesses, so I have to also to see the strategy of the plan, where do we want to go, how is the earnings that we are doing, how far we are earning money, where are we losing money, all these kind of things that are not only chemistry, I'm also enjoying, and that's a thing that in this company I also can do. Learn different technologies, not also synthesis from amine, so change to polymers if you need. Do production from solid chemistry, do production from liquid chemistry, gas chemistry, and all the limitations also that brings doing chemistry to applications in life. And of course, not everything is nice, so I also have to face challenges. First challenge that I got when I arrived here is that you are coming here with a luggage and you have to open a bank account. You don't have the language. So when I decided to come to Germany, but I couldn't speak the language. And I was expecting that in a global company, I will be able also to learn it. I was lucky because in my postdoc time, I was able to learn German. In the postdoc, we were talking in English, but when I started in the company, my first challenge was to lead a group of people. All of them were men and older than me, and they couldn't speak in English. So I had to lead a group with the problem or the challenge that we couldn't understand each other. And everything has to be written in paper. And yes, chemistry is in the paper, but these kind of technicians, there are some people that they want to know what's happening in the chemistry, but there are some other people that they don't care what's happening in the chemistry. They only want a recipe, tell me what I have to do, and I will do it in the best way. And that was the first challenge that I was finding here, that it was how to bring them what I wanted to do in order to achieve my goal. Also, you enter in a company as a PhD student in a lab team leader position, and you are together with the best PhD students that apply to this company. That means that maybe you don't find the friendly environment that you have at the ICIQ or at the university. Is where you start to see that you have real competition, or that they are not so kind maybe to help you because you could be a competitor in their careers. And then they start the sharks and the gorillas, and they're pushing each other. And then also when you, what you want is to do your job and do it in the best way that you can, you have to become a fighter at the end, or try to find also your place without to be impolite, but you have also to be strong and say, I'm here. Also, Noelia was talking, you have to make a difference. You cannot be like the other ones. So you have to be, you have to find your unique, the USP and make the difference. And one of the things that helped me a lot in this company is keep the person that I always been. As the colleagues say, I'm laughing. I'm bringing also fun in every place that I come. And one of the things that I decide not to do, and that's really typical in BSF, all the PhD are called Herr Doctor, Frau Doctor Huguet in my case, and I decided I didn't want to go for that. I wanted to be called Núria, and I wanted to tell the people in the same level, always keeping that at the end they have to do more or less the things that I wanted to achieve the goals, but always from the same look, from the same side, and always being able to hear the others, because when you are leading people, you have to be also in the position to be able to listen to them. Maybe they are coming with really nice ideas that maybe you didn't think about that. And that also was really nice to learn here. One of the things that I have to fight to go through at the beginning in the first week in my job of BSF, I thought that they will quit me. It's because, as I say, when you are putting a reaction here, you have to go through a lot of paper of safety. And my first reaction, I will never forget that, was with sodium hydride. Sodium hydride, 99%. And I was doing all the safety talks with the technician. And of course, you have to also keep in mind that in these big companies, the position are always rotating. So that means that I wasn't the first boss that they had. I was maybe the number 15. So they are used to become a new academical that they call from a foreign country and start from zero. But at the end, they are fed up because they are telling, I know what you are telling me. I know that. I'm Núria. We are here already 20 years. And what happened? That I did all the safety and I told them, please work on the glove box and only bring that out if it's under inert atmosphere. What happened? I came in the lab at the next day at 7:30. I was the first from my group. All my colleagues were still at home. And when I entered the lab, I just could see in the fume hood fire. And one person that was completely broke in front of the fume hood. And to be honest, I didn't thought that I could react so normal or so keep calm. And I just took sand and removed the fire and tried to isolate it. And the problem was that the colleague told him, and you know, Núria is just new. I was working always with sodium hydride outside from the human food. She's just exaggerating. She's scared about the chemistry. You can do that in the outside from the glove box, in the balance. What happened that the colleague was working with sodium hydride 60% and they forgot that difference. So that was one of the first challenges, like, the first reaction that they were doing for me, I got fire. I had to go to the whole safety program. I had to go to the crisis management. I had to tell my boss, and I was thinking, oh my God, they are going to hire me. But no, we're well, and I'm here, but I learned from that. And that helped me also to build the trust on the team. That's also really important when you are working with other people, and at the end you want to achieve the goal, you need to build this trust with them. You need to trust them, you need to explain where do you want to go, you need to, as I say, listen to them and build this trust that at the end they come to the place that you want. Of course, I had to lead with a lot of chemical troubleshooting. So why the catalyst is not doing what you want, why suddenly they are solids in the reactor, why the pump is not working because you have products that you didn't expect, and stop it. And also one of the things that I most learned here was the taking decisions fast. And that's a thing that I have to face in production, because suddenly you are receiving a call from another plant that is telling you, sorry, Núria, but the product that we are producing now, this secondary product that should be in less 0.1% is 0.8% and it's for pharma. And what should we do now? And then you need to think really fast in which consequences could that have in your reactor. So in my case that I'm working with ethylene oxide, is this component gonna react with ethylene oxide? What is gonna bring? Could we train it to separate it? We couldn't. Yes, no. Do we have the time to run experiments with the research teams or not? And at the end, you have to make really fast decisions. Worse are the decisions that are related to safety from your coworkers. And that's one of the things that really keeps me also growing and doing. And I like my job also because of that. One of the things that I most love in production is that you don't know how your day is going to be. You know when you start, you don't know when you are going to finish. I don't have the same problem as Noelia since I don't have kids, so I'm still flexible. But I also want to keep my job balance. So balance between job and my personal life. And of course, I have to be always available because if something happens, I'm not called directly because for that, that's my the plant manager, the one that it's called, and then the production manager. So process manager is coming later or when they have chemistry problems, but still you have to be available and facing all the challenges. That for me is more like an application in the real life. And what I would like to that you take home, or what I think as the same things that the Noelle and I'm sure that Margot were saying, it's about networking, work hard, but make you competent, make a difference with the rest, be persistent, fight for the things that you want, never give up, fight. And challenge yourself. Think out of the box, go out from your comfort area. I put here three sentences that I'm listening since I'm also from colleagues here in BSF, that there is no elevator success. You must take the stairs. So it's a step by step. And in these stairs, you will find stones on the way and you have to overcome them. It's like hiking a mountain. The higher you get, the harder it is because the altitude matters, take longer to become and heavier. But as I say, keep going and there's not always, the things are not always like you plan. Sometimes a path is blocked and then you must go another way. And see, like Michael Limbach always told me, keep the fire, never lose it. And for me, how I will define a career, it doesn't matter if it's in the industry, if it's in the academical world, at the end a career is a marathon. It takes long, you keep going until the end and fighting, and it's not a sprint. So keep your energy, and thank you very much for listening to me. I hope that I could bring you a bit how the industry or challenges are, or how I took the decisions that I took in life. And I would like to thank, of course, Antonio and all my colleagues from that time in the ICIQ and all the group leaders that helped me in that moment. These were my colleagues in Harvard. These are here the colleagues from Carla, from the postdoctoral center from the BSF. Here you can see these are my team members. As I said, older people, so it's not always about chemistry. It's also about thinking about jubilation. They are also the retirement, life from the colleagues, and other kind of thinking that they have. This was my team from the operational excellence in production, and this is my actually so part of the plant colleagues during the pandemic. Thank you very much again, Judith, for this kind invitation, and I'm happy to hear from you questions if you have, and you can always contact me if you are interested in the industry, if you want to know more. There you have my email contact, and as I say, thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Núria, to you for your presentation, and sorry for the short interruption that you had during your presentation. It seemed that somebody unmuted the microphone without realizing. And then it's time for questions, so please don't be shy, ask whatever you want. We still have some minutes before finishing the event. It seems that everything was really clear, Núria.
I hope so. If not, you can always contact me. I hope that I didn't talk a lot because we are already late, but thank you.
Well, I only have a curiosity, Núria. I'm not sure if you can say that now you have finally found your place, let's say there at the BASF, or you, or have you ever thought about the possibility of coming again here to Spain to continue with your professional career?
I think I won't be here forever.
But you don't know.
I would like to go back to Spain, but it's the same like in the academical world. It's not that easy neither in the industry. When you have so many possibilities in such a big company here in Germany that you can change path so easily, going back to Spain, I would like, but could be also the possibility that I land up in another country that is neither Spain. So I don't think that I will stay here the whole life.
Okay. So it seems that there are no questions, and maybe we should start. Oh, GR has a question.
Yeah. Thank you for your talk, Núria, and congratulations on your success. Yes, since nobody wanted to ask, just let me ask you a general question. I know that you are more on production, not so much on research, but I assume that even in your position in Germany, you have close contacts with research centers or technology centers.
Yes.
How can this be translated to Spain? How can we improve this? Or how can this be the way we can get, because as you know, the ICIQ is not so easy.
You mean in terms from collaborations?
Yes, or collaborations or research projects. How much do you trust? Or
lot of the things in BSF are going through the postdoctoral centers. For example, a lot of professors from Berkeley University, they are collaborating with BSF in the postdoctoral center that is with CARA. It's called CARA. And then they are doing their chemistry related with BSF. Also the same with the postdoctoral center from Heidelberg, where I did the postdoc. But I'm not that fit there, but the ITQ from Valencia, they had some collaborations also with the zeolites group from here in Ludwigshafen. When the president, so to say, from the boss from BSF Spain came to Ludwigshafen, some Spanish people, we already say that I'm coming from the ICIQ, we have our production site in Tarragona, and I never had contact. We know BSF there because at that moment, and I don't know, I think they are still doing, they are supporting with the seminars on Fridays in the ICIQ. That's a thing that I know that there is a colleague now in charge in Spain, and he would like to start to get more contact from the university and keep this, start this kind of collaborations, because I think it's a pity to have the ICIQ there and maybe not have this kind of interaction with BSF or other companies. But here in Germany, the companies like Bayer, like BSF, they are having a lot of contact with the universities around. And that's a thing that we could get better.
Thank you very much, and thank you for your support.
No, thank you. It was nice to see you again.
Good to see you. Have a good one.
Okay, so if there are no questions, I'll give the word again to Professor Emilio Palomares, ICIQ Director, who will officially close the event. Emilio, are you here?
Yes, yes, I'm here. I was listening to the second and the last talk. I missed Margot's talk, but I will try to share with you one nice picture I have here. Let me check. Can I share that?
Yeah, we can see it.
Yeah, you can see it?
Yes, now.
Yeah, okay. So that was my last trip to visit Margot in Holland. I promised her that I will visit again, but as you know, I got busy and also the COVID has not allowed us to travel. But I promised Margot that I will go and see you and Danny as soon as I can. And yep, well, I mean, I as I was saying at the beginning, the idea of these days is to keep in touch with all of you. And as you can see, there are many different pathways and experience that the people from the ICIQ have. Of course, we would like to expand this to more days and hear more about your experience and so on. But yeah, the time is what we have. We have only one day. And as you can see, those people who have been ICIQ, there is one thing which is common for everyone. They are very talkative, so they could be talking for hours about their experience. So I will not make this much longer. So what I would like to share with you is this idea that ICIQ is the beginning of things. And it doesn't really matter at the end what are your goals. As Núria has said, sometimes you make plans, but not often happens what you wish. And we know that this can happen so often. So you have to be ready to adapt and move on. And you can be a chemist, but you can be also working in a company and being the development management, or you can take care of the financial office, or you can be working on the lab, or maybe you are a school teacher. What it matters is that you always remember that we are here. And when you need us, we'll be there for you, because this is what makes ICIQ stronger year by year. So we have almost 20 years since that was created. So now there's a lot of people from ICIQ around the world. And you will not imagine how much emails sometimes I get from people now that tell me, that they email me saying, you know, how proud they are that they have found jobs because they have letters from the ICIQ to support their applications. Okay, last week, the last one we signed it as a director. It has been a guy who was in India and he had got now a job in the patent office. Okay, so keep moving, don't stop, and remember that we are very proud of all of you. And with that, I wish you a very nice weekend. You are not lucky because you are not in the list of personal ICIQs. Otherwise, you will receive the Friday song as everybody else every Friday. This Friday was just for you. It was for the ICIQ Alumni Day, and it was back to black of ACDC. I was trying to put it here, but don't worry. You can go to YouTube and look it, but that's my song for you all today. Thank you very much for coming here, and I hope I see you next year. Hopefully, if we can, we'll be do it at the ICIQ Auditorium, and I promise that you will be invited. So, take care.
Thank you very much, Emilio. Just a thing before finishing, and is that I want to thank to all of you for being here with us today, especially to the three of our speakers, but of course to all the people who has participated in the videos. Thank you very much, and well, let's start the weekend. Thank you. See you. Bye.